At Zoster Harley-Davidson in Ames, customers are like family. So whether you're looking for a new bike or for Harley brand gear and gifts, you can count on Zoster to have just what you need. Stop by Zoster Harley-Davidson in Ames, online at AmesZosterHD.com.
Lazer 103.3 Morning Moose Show, where it's time to meet what?
Stop scaring all the rock girls.
How am I scaring the rock girls?
Moose literally looks at them dead in the eye before we go on air and goes, "Don't F up." That's what he does.
How is that scary?
I'm bringing I'm prepared for this.
I'm bringing you some truth. Bringing you some good advice.
It's okay. That's
good, clean, hard advice. Get that mic near your face there, Mickayla.
Got it.
How are you?
I am doing great. How about you?
Good. $40,000 rock girl search. You made it to the top 10. Congrats.
Thanks. Super excited.
Where were you when you found out?
I was at home, actually, in my bed.
Were you listening?
I was listening on my phone to the Listen Live. Yes.
Wait, so when we announced them, they didn't know?
No.
Oh, no, I had no idea.
I thought we called them like ahead of time. We're like, "You're top 10," and then we announced
I had a video going of me like going crazy.
Yeah.
That's insane. Okay. I didn't know that.
So, you're in bed. What were you wearing?
Well, just sweatpants. Nothing too cool.
Oh, okay. Nothing sexy. You're not wearing like
a
teddy or...
sitting there laying with my cats.
You mean you don't have pillow fights with girls every weekend?
In your panties? Yeah.
Right.
No,
yeah.
It's not
and
what happens.
Like,
up over here.
You know, have a,
I really get the ratings going.
Right.
Get
some
more
Harvey's
votes.
Bristol cream in you and start lezzing out a little bit with the girls.
You mean you don't just play with chocolate syrup every...
This is every man's fantasy. Let's don't kill it.
Literally, all girls do when we hang out is eat, fart, and talk about guys. And drink wine.
Yeah.
My wife said girls don't go to the bathroom and poop. They just go in there and meet with unicorns.
Meet with unicorns.
Yes. Feed the unicorns. So, Mickayla, you're from Des Moines.
Yes.
Do you live here?
Yes.
Okay.
I live, like, actually right down the road. It took me, like, 7 minutes to get here.
Bring your microphone closer to your mouth. I don't know.
I didn't walk.
There we go.
I definitely didn't walk
It's
here,
okay. No. I live a whole four blocks, and I walked out today, and I was like, it is 60 degrees outside, too cold.
Yeah,
let me get
definitely
my car.
Driving.
Let me get my car.
You are a bartender?
Yes, I'm a bartender at Buffalo Wild Wings. I've been with the company for about 4 years now since they built it on Southeast 14th.
Oh, so you're at that location?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Okay.
Love
that
job.
One's been there 4 years?
Yes.
Oh, wow. That's,
time goes
like
by really fast.
It seems like it's only been there about a year or so. So what's your, are you the cocktail type of bartender where you can throw the bottles in the air and make like any drink? Or are you the bartender that's like, "I'd like a slow, long screw against the wall," and you're like, you don't know what that is. You think they're hitting on you.
Here's a Bud Light instead.
Just give you a Bud Light. Maybe a Bloody Mary. How about that?
Enjoy your wings.
We're not allowed to flip bottles at Buffalo Wild Wings. And if we did, I don't know how. Then I don't want to attempt it because inventory, they would definitely not be happy with me if I dropped it.
Sure.
Yeah.
Can you make rainbow shots?
We can.
You're losing points, Mickayla. Make the rainbow shot.
I can. You just layer out the shot. Like you do grenadine and then you do like.
Oh.
Yep. Like you layer out the shot. And I know how to layer shots and everything like that. Because we make like snake bites, which is Guinness and Angry Orchard. So you have to layer that out too. It's actually a really, really pretty drink. So
that involves like a spoon, right? And
yes,
slow
it does.
Pour.
Yes. A very slow pour. Yes.
Seems like a waste
very
of time.
Slow.
But with
you
the
ever have anybody order like, "Give me 12 rainbow shots"? Where you
no.
got to do that 12 times?
No, and they're not allowed to. We're corporate, so we don't let people get trashed.
Yeah,
we cut people off, and
what's the worst?
Fun.
What's the worst drunk face McGee you've encountered?
Fight night. This guy, I tried cutting.
Fight night. What?
Yeah.
Conor McGregor?
Yes.
And
this guy got super crazy. I tried cutting him off, and my other bartender, he's a guy, and he didn't notice. And I just started freaking out on this guy because he told me to shut the F up and get out of his house.
What?
And I'm like, excuse me? I'm
this
like, for
is
what?
My house.
Yeah, I was literally like, this is my house. Like, I've been here since the beginning. I was like, this is not your house. I was like, I don't know where you think you are. And so we just got into it. Finally, I just like snapped at my manager and was like, get over here. I yelled at security because we had security that night. Because that's how crazy it gets on fight night. And so they came over, and then like the guy was talking about like how he's gonna sue us and all this stuff for cutting him off.
Wow.
Yeah. Drunk people love to play that "I'm gonna get a lawyer" card.
Yeah, I'm gonna get a lawyer. I've got a lawyer, I'm suing you. What's your name? This and this. And I'm like, I really don't care. You're not going to be able to sue us for this reason.
Did he sue you?
No, he didn't.
He probably didn't remember the next day.
I had to ask, you know.
He probably got home and was like, did I even pay my tab?
Right.
He definitely did. We made sure of that.
So, Mickayla, why do you want to be the rock girl? What made you come out to the audition? It was Jordan Creek, right?
Yes, it was. It was Jordan Creek. So I was always talking about it, and then I went and looked online, and their audition was that day. So I just went up there and did it. I've always wanted to do it. Me and my stepdad, we used to listen to Lazer all the time when I was little, and so like I would hear about these rock girls, and I thought like they were like a good figure and like cool for someone to look up to and be. And so I always wanted to do it, and it seemed like a very fun job, and the concerts, and of course winning the 40,000 cash and prizes. But I'm more like doing all the stuff just seems more fun to me.
Did you know that Moose's wife was a rock girl?
I did not know this. I actually read up on you because before I got here, I know you're married with two kids. I know you're like American dad and family guy. I know you're actually not a morning person.
What'd you learn about me? Tell me what you learned about me.
I don't get that far now.
What? You only read about Moose?
I read about Moose. That's all anybody cares about. Me.
Right.
And I knew that he was going to say something crazy, so I was going to like try to think of something crazy to say back.
Right.
But there was nothing bad on there. So I was like, of course. And then the pizza. I was going to ask you questions about yourself, and then I was going to bring that pizza from 9th.
She had it all.
You're going to bring that pizza from where?
On 9th.
Oh, it's not there anymore.
It's not? Well, good thing I didn't try this morning.
Yeah.
She did that so much research.
I did. Like, I was, like, nervous.
That would have gotten you some points there, Mickayla. I love that Tia's pizza. So you want to be the $40,000 rock girl. What's the prize, the one prize that you're looking forward to the most if you win?
The concerts. Tickets.
Okay.
Yeah. And
you know, a lot of people say concert tickets.
I'm like, I'm worried about the shipwreck cruise and going on vacation.
But like, it's two people, and I would have no idea who to bring because I have like several different friends, so I don't even want to get into that.
If you offer to take me or Moose, you'll probably get some problems.
You'd find. I'm sure that wouldn't be that hard.
No.
Well, we'd have a lot of fun together.
Yeah. Have you gotten? I was talking to the girls at some of the location stops because you were busy. You were at work. And have you started getting, like, the creeper Facebook messages, Facebook requests?
I had some guy ask for a picture of my feet because I'm a contestant.
Oh, Ryan Patrick.
And the Lazer Rock Girl search. And I said, I'm not sending. He's like, all the girls do. I was like, I highly doubt that. I'm not sending
he
you
said,
a picture of my toes.
You should have negotiated a fee or something.
A fee?
$100 I'll send you. It's a picture of your feet.
And yeah, that's what he kept saying. He was like, it's not like it's a nude. It's just a picture of your toes. And I'm like, that's still weird. Sending you a picture of my toes. Like, where is this gonna go?
You should have sent him the not PayPal, but the
Venmo.
Send him a Venmo. Like, put $100 in there, and I'll send you pictures of my
little piggies. Go on Google, find the nastiest pair of cracked feet.
Oh, that'd be funny.
And then, you know, just be like, oh, this is for you, Big Daddy.
Like, pictures of George the Animal Steel's feet after he just wrestled for 2 hours straight.
Yeah. Imagine these toes on your chest.
I'm not like the type of person that gets their like nails and toes done like all the time. Like, never going to be that girl. So, of course, my toenails, like, aren't painted all the way. They're, like, chipped and stuff. So, I'm not about to send you a picture of my feet.
Mine are absolutely disgusting.
Oh, here we go. Send a picture, one of those pictures.
Of those feet? Oh, God.
I don't know if the camera can picture that.
I totally
hammer toe.
Go through my messages now and do this.
I have a hammer toe. I do.
Do you really?
Yeah, it doesn't. It can't move.
Brody. Mickayla in the $40,000 Rock Girl search. If you want to vote for Mickayla, go to laser1033.com and click on the main Rock Girl thing and then click on Mickayla's. You can vote on her. Click on her little button there.
Her little button.
I just voted for you.
Ooh.
Oh. Visit her at Buffalo Wild Wings.
And ask her about sausages.
And ask her about sausages.
And her toes.
And her toes.
Sausages
and toes.
Mickayla, good luck to you.
Thank you.
Do you know real quick what campaign stop you're going to be at?
I will be at this Sunday, 7 to 9, at Spectators.
Okay.
Yep.
So go see Mickayla at Spectators this Sunday, 7 to 9, while you're watching the game. Thank you, Mickayla. Good luck.
Thank you, Marty Moose.